Morning students, last class we learned the lesson, the lost child. Let us recapitulate. We learned that a small boy who is going along with his parents to the fair. So he was attracted by so many things on the way. Now let us continue with the lesson. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. As they neared the village, actually they are supposed to go through the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs. Throngs means crowd. When they were going on the way, he had seen a lot of crowd converging. Converging means meeting to the whirlpool of the fair. Whirlpool means center of the fair. A lot of crowd was there on the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. That is, and felt, he himself felt at once repelled, driven away, and fascinated by, attracted by the confusion of the world. There was a lot of confusion. Where was there a lot of confusion? In the fair, a lot of confusion means so many people were there, so many shops were there. That is the confusion. The child was entering. A sweetmeat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasagulla, barfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed round his counter at the foot of an architecture of many coloured sweet. So the moment he entered the fair, he was attracted by a sweet shop. What are the things? What was hawked? He was selling the things. How they used to say that thing? Like we people have seen during the evening time, if you go to the bus stand or railway station, they used to sell the newspaper. Evening newspaper. They used to speak and they used to ask the people to purchase it. The sweetmeat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi. Railway station, chai vada, you must have seen. That is quite familiar, isn't it? Same way, the sweetmeat seller is asking the people to come and purchase gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi and jalebi. At the corner of the entrance, and that was the entrance, corner of the entrance, the sweet shop was there. And a crowd pressed round his counter at the foot of an architecture of many coloured sweets. Many coloured sweets were exhibited in that sweet shop. So, a lot of people were attracted towards the sweet shop. Decorated with leaves of silver and gold. How the sweets were decorated? He used the different leaves. Which colour? Silver and gold. The child stared open-eyed, and his mouth watered for the barfi. That was his favorite sweet. I want that barfi, he slowly murmured. The child was attracted towards the sweets, and his mouth was filled with what? Water. Why? Because barfi is his favorite sweet. And he himself said, I want that barfi. He slowly murmured. He very slowly said, but he half knew as he begged that his plea would not be heeded because his parents would say he was greedy. But he very well knew that the parents are not going to purchase the sweets for him. And that's why. But he half knew as he begged that his plea, plea means request, would not be heeded. Heeded means paid attention. Would not be heeded means nobody will pay attention to his request. Because what was his request? He wanted to purchase barfi. Because his parents would say he was greedy. What will be the parents' opinion? The boy is very greedy. In the beginning, he said he wanted to purchase that that toys, isn't it? So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So he was, even though he wanted to eat barfi, but he did not say, because he knew very well that the parents are not going to purchase him what? Purchase him the sweet. So he just moved on. He just said, but he was moving forward. Then a flower seller hawked a garland of gulmohar. A garland of gulmohar. Garland, you all know, mala, isn't it? Which is made of what? Gulmohar flower. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. He cannot resist himself. So he was drawn towards the which shop? To the flower seller's shop. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured. He had seen a basket full of what was there? The flowers were there. What did he murmur? I want that garland. He was very literally, he is greedy, isn't it? So what did he want now? He wanted the garland. But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So he was attracted towards, first he was attracted towards the what? The sweets. Next he wanted to purchase the garland, but he very well knew that who is not going to purchase that for him? The parents will not purchase that for him. So the next paragraph, a man stood holding a pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. Next, he was attracted towards the balloon seller. How he used to hold the balloons? He was holding a pole. A pole with what? Yellow color, red color, green color and purple color balloons were there. So he was attracted. He was going towards the balloon seller. It was, he's saying that it is rainbow glory of their silken colors. And he was filled with the overwhelming desire. What is overwhelming? Means excessive. Excessive desire. Desire is wish to possess them all. He feels like purchasing all the different colored balloons, but he very well knew his parents would never buy him the balloons because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. So he walked on further. So he knew very well that if he wanted to purchase or if he'll ask the parents to purchase the balloons for him, who will not pay attention? The parents will not pay attention to him. So what will they say? They will say, you are such a grown up boy. You are not supposed to play with what? Play with the balloon. So he didn't say anything. He just moved forward. Next one. What was the next one you see? A snake charmer stood playing a flute to a snake which coiled itself in a basket. Its head raised in a graceful bend like the neck of a swan, while the music stole into its invisible ears like the gentle rippling of an invisible waterfall. Now he is attracted by a snake charmer. What was the snake charmer doing? He was playing flute, and the snake was coiled. Coiled means wriggled. It was inside the basket and it was coming out of the basket. While the music stole into his invisible ears like the gentle rippling, the music is compared to the what? The waves of an invisible waterfall. Here rippling is the waves of an waterfall. The child went towards the snake charmer. So he was attracted next by the whom? By the snake charmer. But knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such crass music as the snake charmer played, he proceeded further. But he knew that the father will, or the parents will say that music, that is very rough music, you are not supposed to go there. So he just proceeded further. He just walked ahead. There was a roundabout in full swing. Men, women and children, carried away in the whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. The child watched them intently, and then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. Now, next is coming about the rides, isn't it? So, men and children, they were very happy and they were all riding in the different types of what? The rides, and they were shrieking, they were shouting and crying with dizzy laughter. Dizzy means confused laughter. The child was also watching those rides very eagerly. Intently means eagerly. And then he made a bold request. Then he gathered all courage and he requested his parents, I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. He wanted to go into that particular ride. What did he do? He requested his parents. There was no reply. Who did not give any reply? The parents did not give any reply. He turned to look at his parents. They were not there. Then he realized that the parents were not there. Ahead of him. He just checked in front of him. There also his parents were not there. He turned to look on either side. Both the sides he checked. His parents were not there. They were not there. He looked behind. He turned back and checked. There was no sign of them. So he was lost. A full deep cry rose within his dry throat, and with a sudden jerk of his body, he ran from where he stood, crying in real fear, "Mother, father!" Tears rolled down from his eyes, hot and fierce. His flushed face was convulsed with fear. Now you see, now he is not attracted towards anything else. Now he knew that he was lost. So what did he do? He was started running here and there and shouting, "Father and mother!" Tears rolled down. He was crying also, hot and fierce. He was very fierce to one side first, then to the other, and hither and thither in all directions he was running, knowing not where to go. He doesn't know that where to go and find his parents. "Mother, father!" he wailed. He cried. Wailed means he cried. His yellow turban came untied and his clothes became muddy. So he was in a rush. No, he was full of, his clothes were full of mud, and his turban also untied. Turban, you all know, isn't it? The just like cloth they use and tie it on the head. Having run to and fro in a rage of running for a while, he stood defeated, his cries suppressed into sobs. Now his sob means vidumbi karaya, isn't it? And at little distances on the green grass, he could see through his filmy eyes men and women talking. So he was looking around and he had seen who were talking. The men and women were talking. He tried to look intently among the patches of bright yellow clothes, but there was no sign of his father and mother among these people, who seemed to laugh and talk just for the sake of laughing and talking. He had seen a crowd of people there. He just checked whether his parents were there. There intently means very eagerly he checked among them whether his parents were there, but they were missing. The rest of the people were all laughing and talking. He ran quickly again, this time to a shrine to which people seemed to be crowding. Every little inch of space there was congested with them. There was a holy place. There a lot of people were gathered. He just went inside, but he ran through the people's legs. He was a small boy, so he can go through the people's legs. His little sob lingering, he was continuously crying, "Mother, father!" Near the entrance to the temple, however, the crowd became very thick. When he reached the entrance of the temple, the crowd was very much. The men jostle means pushing to each other. Heavy men with flashing murderous eyes and hefty shoulders. They were all very fat and people and hefty shoulders. It was very difficult for him to go in front of the temple. The poor child struggled to thrust away between their feet. He was struggling very hard to push away between their feet, but knocked to and fro by their brutal movements. Very cruelly their movements, very rough movements they had. So he just fell down. He might have been trampled underfoot. Trampled means crush. He was about to crumbled under their foot, and had he not shrieked at the highest pitch of his voice. What happened? People were about to crush him, but by the time he just shouted, "Father, mother!" A man in the surging crowd heard his cry. The one person heard his cry. And stooping with great difficulty, lifted him up in his hands. Stooping means bending. The one man heard his cry and he just bent and took him in his arms. "How did you get here, child?" That was the first question that person asked. "How did you reach here? Whose baby are you? Where are your parents?" That's what the man asked. The man asked as he steered clear of the mass. Steered means came out of the crowd. Who came out of the crowd? The man who was carrying this boy. The child wept more bitterly than ever, now, and only cried. The boy was actually very badly crying. Now he just cried and said, "I want my mother. I want my father." So that's why the people used to say, when you go out in a crowded place, you have to be with whom? You have to be with the parents. What did the boy do? The boy was attracted by so many things in the fair, isn't it? So he was lost. The man tried to soothe him, Soothe means console him by taking him to the roundabout. So the boy, man was actually diverting his attention. So he asked the boy, do you want to go to the rides? See, taking him to the roundabout, will you have a ride on the horse? Do you want to ride on the horse? He gently asked as he approached the ring. The child's throat tore into a thousand shrill sobs and he only shouted, I want my mother, I want my father. Now the child doesn't want to go to any ride. Even the man was ready to take him to the ride, but the boy said he wanted only mother and father. The man headed towards the place. Headed means went ahead towards the place where the snake charmer still played on the flute to the swaying cobra. Who was playing the flute? The snake charmer was playing the flute and to the swaying cobra. Swaying means swinging cobra. Listen to that nice music, child, he pleaded. So the man wanted to divert the attention of the child. So he asked the boy to pay attention to whom? Pay attention to the snake charmer's music. But the child shut his ears with his fingers and shouted his double pitch strain. He just closed his ears and he said that. What did he say? I want my mother. I want my father. I don't want to listen to the music of the snake charmer. I just only wanted my parents. The man took him near the balloons, thinking the bright colors of the balloons would distract the child's attention and quieten him. What did the man do? The man is very patient, isn't it? So he took the boy towards whom? Towards the balloon seller. He thought that he is a small boy. He must be interested in purchasing the balloons. So he offered him balloons. What did the boy say? He was not interested. What did he ask? You just see. Would you like a rainbow colored balloon? He persuasively asked. The child turned his eyes from the flying balloons and just sobbed, I want my mother, I want my father, I don't want the balloon, I want only what? I just want my parents. That's what the child said. The man, still trying to make the child happy, bore him to the gate where the flower seller sat. Bore him means carried him to the flower seller's shop. Look, can you smell those nice flowers, child? Would you like a garland to put round your neck? Next, the man asked him, would you like to purchase what? A garland of flowers. So what did he say? What did the child say? The child turned his nose away from the basket and retreated his soap. I want my mother. I want my father. Retreated means repeated. Only he repeat. What did he repeat? He repeated that. I want my mother and I want my father. Now he doesn't need any ride or he doesn't need any sweet. He doesn't need any balloons or garland. Thinking to humor his disconsolate charge by a gift of sweets, the man took him to the counter of the sweet shop. What did the man thought next? To humor his disconsolate means very sad, charged by a gift of what? Gift of sweet. He thought that the child will be happy if he will offer him a basket of sweets. The man took him to the counter of the sweet shop. What sweets would you like, child? He asked. The last choice, the man asked him, what do you want? The child turned his face from the sweet shop and only sobbed, I want my father, I want my mother. So what did the child say? I want only my parents. I don't need anything from this fair. That is the last words of this child. I hope you understood. If you have any doubts, you can call me. Thank you.